The drive and excellence of African-American people has had far-reaching influence in the history of America. Two of the men at the forefront of this never-ending press, General Benjamin Oliver Davis Sr. and his son, Lieutenant General Benjamin Oliver Davis Jr. Benjamin Oliver Davis Sr. was born in July 1877 in Washington, D.C. After having served as a volunteer in the Spanish-American War in 1898, he enlisted as a private in the 9th Cavalry of the United States Army. Davis rose to Sergeant Major within 2 years and earned a commission as a second lieutenant in 1901. He slowly rose through the ranks, spending time as a professor of military science at Wilberforce and Tuskegee Universities and for the Ohio and New York National Guards, before eventually becoming the first African-American colonel in the Army in 1930. In 1940, he was promoted to Brigadier General by President Franklin D. Roosevelt. After commanding the 2nd Cavalry Division in 1941, Davis raised a son who followed in his footsteps. Lieutenant General Benjamin Oliver Davis Jr. was born in Washington, D.C. in 1912 and would become the nation's second African-American general officer and the U.S. Air Force's first African-American general. He was also a commander of the Tuskegee Airmen, which formed the core of the United States Army All-Black 99th Pursuit Squadron during World War II. General Davis Sr. and Lieutenant General Davis Jr. were laid to rest in 1970 and in 2002, respectively. Both men had to endure the racist and segregationist practices of the white-run armed forces, but both of them, in overt and subtle ways, worked to eradicate injustice and model true African-American excellence.